Hi everyone, Aaron here at Yetitool. In this video, we're going to look at the key aspects of CNC cutting strategy. So, what is cutting strategy? It's the cutting methods and values you use for essential parameters. Setting your cutting strategy is done as you create your job file in your CAM software. For this video, we're going to be using Vectric VCarve Pro. Understanding cutting strategy can be the key to taking your CNC work to the next level. Poor strategy can lead to all sorts of problems, such as broken cutters, poor finish, inaccuracies, burnt materials, and damage to both your stock material and your spindle. We know it might seem daunting at first, but by the end of this video, you'll understand that the underlying concepts are very simple. And for the common materials, we've already done the research on what values to enter. So please do check out our material profiles database on our knowledge base. We will continue to add more articles on processing different materials. So if you don't see your material listed, please check back soon. The first thing we'll talk about is spindle speed. This is the speed at which the spindle rotates, measured in revolutions per minute or RPM. The range of SmartBench's spindle speed is between 10,000 and 25,000 RPM. The SmartBench console allows you to adjust and tune the spindle speed during a job. Next, we're going to talk about feed rate. This is the speed at which the cutter moves through the material in the X and Y axis and is measured in distance per minute, such as millimeters per minute. The feed rate on SmartBench can vary between 100 to 8,000 millimeters per minute. The feed rate can also be changed manually during a job on the SmartBench console. Or if you have a SmartBench Precision Pro Plus, you can enable Yeti Pilot, which can adjust the feed rate for you automatically, a world first for CNC routing. For more information on Yeti Pilot, please see our dedicated video and our knowledge base articles. Step down refers to the distance the cutter moves in the Z-axis between each pass. It can also sometimes be referred to as pass depth. The deeper the step down, the more load on your cutter. Overloaded cutters can lead to tool deflection, stalling, and tool breakage. The best strategy for accurate cutting is to have smaller step downs. The plunge rate is the speed that the cutter moves into material in the Z-direction. Like feed rate, this is also measured in millimeters per minute. Be careful of setting the plunge rate too high, as this can damage the cutter. The cutting direction refers to the direction the cutter moves through the material. These are referred to as conventional and climb milling. In conventional milling, the tool rotates against the cutting edge. Whereas in climb milling, the tool rotates with the cutting edge. Because of this, climb milling is more energy efficient than conventional milling. The appropriate cutting direction depends on the material and the cutter you're using. Each has their own benefits depending on what scenario it's being used in. Ramps are an additional aspect of cutting strategy that can be added to your toolpath and are most often used for profile cuts. So, instead of plunging directly down in the Z-axis, the cutter will also move in the X and Y axis as well as the Z-axis down at an angle. Ramps are useful for reducing the load on your cutter as well as preventing tool deflection. They are also crucial when using compression cutters. Also note that the speed of your ramp is dictated by the plunge rate, not your feed rate, since the cutter is moving the Z-axis. A lead-in is another feature that can be added to your toolpath, and like ramps, is often used for profiles. A lead-in will allow the cutter to enter the material outside of the designated path, and then move into the toolpath already at the correct pass depth. They are useful for reducing witness marks and improving accuracy. And they can also be combined with the ramp feature. Next is step over, which is used for toolpaths where you're clearing out areas of material, such as pocketing toolpaths. The cutter will always have 100% contact with the material on the first pass. But for the passes following that, the contact area is determined by the step over value. We typically recommend a step over of around 50%, meaning that after the first pass, only half the diameter of the cutter will be in contact with the stock material. A really important aspect of cutting strategy is the finishing pass, or you might know it as the last pass. The finishing pass cuts a very fine thickness of material up to the edge of the part. This can be used to clean up edges and improve finished part accuracy. This is standard CNC best practice. For more information on finishing passes and how to add them to your job, please see our dedicated knowledge base article. The final aspect of cutting strategy that we'll explain today are the two methods of clearing out pockets of material. When pocketing, you can either use an offset or a raster strategy. And which is more useful depends on the material and the type of cut that you are doing. The offset strategy cuts from the centre out towards the edges, whereas raster simply cuts from one side to the other, but this can be angled. Offset strategies are typically slightly faster, but raster strategies can produce a better finish with some materials such as solid wood. Additionally, changing the angle of the raster can help if there are large strands that might block the extraction. Having a step over of around 50% is also important for effective extraction. So these are the key strategy terms and methods you need to understand to make sure your CNC projects come out looking great. The versatility of SmartBench and CNC routing means that your strategy will vary between each and every job. And remember, there's no single best strategy you can employ for all of your jobs. Proficiency with knowing what's best in your context comes with experience. But please do refer to our knowledge base and CNC Academy for values to get you started. So we hope this video has helped you understand the key aspects of CNC cutting strategy. And we wish you the very best of luck in all your CNC endeavours. Hopefully you found this useful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.